It is a pity that patients cannot sometimes appreciate the difference between hunger and appetite. It would help us to ask them how often they need to eat or if they can go long hours without eating. What time of day are they most hungry? How large are their portions of food? How is their energy when they are hungry after eating? And what do they eat most of the time? What and how much do they drink? So generally, hunger and thirst follow the same rule. Therefore, should be high at the same time or low in the same person. If in some patients, hunger is less and thirst is higher or vice versa, then our diagnosis should be made on the information based on thirst. Again, if the patient talks at night, thirst, you should check to see if they have nasal obstruction, which means they should breathe through their mouth all night, this making their throat dry and thirsty. In other words, thirst is a symptom of the stomach, and other organs causing the same symptom should be excluded. So we have here the first tower diagram. Deficient yung yang, stomach yang, and qi deficiency, less hunger and thirst. Next is there is a stomach yin deficiency, so there is less appetite. Next, there is a stomach hyperactive functional qi, excessive hunger, intolerance to hunger. Next tower diagram, spleen and stomach, poor function, there is a qi deficiency. So, sleepy after eating. And last, next tower diagram, there is a retention of food in the stomach, heaviness, fullness, and lethargy after eating, worst in the evening. Next tower diagram, there is heat in the stomach, which is excess of yang, preference for cold food and drink. Next tower diagram, there is cold in the stomach. It's either excess yin or normal yung yin, deficient yung yang. There is preference for hot food and drinks. Next, there is excess yin, deficient ang qi. Stomach, there is nausea, passive symptoms after eating. Next tower diagram, normal ang yin, deficient ang qi. So stomach, meron siyang nausea, passive symptoms on empty stomach. Next tower diagram, normal ang yin, excess ang yang. Stomach, vomiting, active symptoms after eating. And last tower diagram, deficient ang yin, excess yung yang. So sa stomach pa rin, vomiting, active symptoms on empty stomach. So sa treatment, we need to improve stomach qi, yung function. We use UB20, UB21, which is the Bakshu point of spleen or stomach. We use stomach 40, which is the Lu point, tonifies function, removes stagnation. Stomach 36, house element point, improves yang and qi. Eat more in the morning and light meals in the evening. PC6, distal point for upper abdomen, reduces fullness. To improve appetite, we use REN 12, which is the Mu point of the stomach, spleen 2 or 3, tonification point, house element point. Stomach 43, the Wood point, tonifies stomach yin on the controlling cycle. PC6, area distal point for upper abdomen. For the hyperactive stomach function, we use REN 12, the Mu point, cools and calms. Spleen 21, the major Lu point, tonifies yin and sedates yang. Stomach 43 controls stomach yang and tonifies yin on controlling cycle. Milk products. Retention of food in the stomach, same as points for improving function. We just add point spleen 9 to sedates yin of stomach indirectly.